Do you want to sell or acquire a property? REHub and My Hometown Realty and Developer, with a wide range of real estate services for individual, corporate, or business clients, from brokerage, project selling, to property management, leasing, engineering, appraisal services, documentation services. Real Estate Hub, 25 years in the real estate industry. Our chairman, Ms. Margaret Gaw, a licensed real estate broker and a certified international property specialist. Our president, Dr. Mary Gaw So, a licensed broker, appraiser, and consultant. Certified international property specialist, 2019 ASEAN Real Estate Network Alliance Arena top broker. Our CEO, Mr. Winston Gaw, together with his wife, Claire Gaw, handle international linkages. Check out our website at www.realestatehub.com.ph. Let me introduce someone who originally belongs to the field of science, then cross over to the property market with unprecedented achievements in both fields. Since then, she has been an expert in all fields of real estate profession, whether in brokerage, appraisal, and consultancy. It is seldom we see someone as relentless and consistent as her in getting things done and reaching greater heights of success in every endeavor she ventures in. You won't miss her in the crowd because her presence are all over in different organizations, local and international conventions and events, charitable institutions, print and social media, weekly webinars, teaching profession, and most recently in the teleradio Real Talk Real Estate at CBRC.TV every Saturday 7 in the evening in her regular weekly show. Despite her numerous awards and recognitions, she never stops investing on learning by surrounding herself with people who are considered top-notch leaders in their own right. Complimented with a positive energy, vibrant personality, and a generous heart, she makes sure that sharing her blessings to her family, friends, and business associates is simply being steadfastly faithful and grateful to our Lord Jesus Christ. Again, the person I'm referring holds 8 licenses. She is a licensed optometrist, licensed real estate broker, appraiser and consultant, a licensed international life coach, licensed management coach, certified international property specialist. While among her business interests and affiliations include president of her own group of companies, REHub Real Estate Hub, My Hometown Realty Development Corporation, Tronics Master Incorporated, BGC Hostel and Hotel, Garves Boutique Hotel, RVAS Rehab Valuation and Advisory Services, Sightsaver Optical Clinic, past president of Barib, Quezon City Realty Board, most popular lady of Barib, or the Philippine Association of Real Estate Boards, past president of Real Estate Brokers Association of the Philippines Incorporated QC Chapter, past national president of Para 2010, the Premier Association of Appraiser, used to be the faculty member of Trinity University of Asia, Bachelor of Science in Real Estate Management, used to be the faculty member of LaSalle St. Benilde on its special course, Appraisal and Property Management, Council Member of Federation of Filipino-Chinese Chamber of Commerce and Industry Incorporated, FFCCCII, past President of Soroptimist Ortigas and Environs, members of many associations, such as the Management Association of the Philippines, Philippine Marketing Association, the Philippine Association of Building Administration, PCCIQC, San Juan Lions Club, Makati Tourism Foundation, Director of Spirit Field Ministry for Outreaches. Her life verse, Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Mary Gaw So.
Hey Hello, everyone. Good evening again. It's another Saturday learning for everyone. And I'm so excited for tonight dahil as every Saturday, we really have a lot of mga surprises here at CBRC.TV. So every Saturday, tune in from 7 to 8 o'clock because we're back here in Real Talk Real Estate. And for tonight, alam mo, napaka-full, kumbaga jam-pack, no? Talagang medyo powerhouse talaga ang ating mga bisita for tonight. And because this is the first Saturday of February, and alam natin, napakabilis, kailan lang nag-New Year. Ngayon, February na, mamaya, Valentine's Day na, then Pasko na naman, no? But again, it's a never-ending learning Saturday with CBRC.TV. And we know, as in real estate tayo, we have to know a lot of things, no? Sa ating investment, sa ating field. Because why? We have to know a lot of mga earth movement like in infrastructure project, which the opportunities are waiting. And of course, infrastructure project that will revolutionize in Central Luzon. I just purposely zoom in, no, sa Central Luzon. Why? Dahil napakarami naman talagang development nationwide. Maraming magagandang development sa South, maraming magagandang development sa Cebu, sa Davao. Like now, I'm here in Cagayan de Oro, streaming live, no, dito sa SEDA Hotel. Sabi ko, walang excuse because it's Saturday, but I just had my dinner with the family of Sir Willie Limbonhay. Thank you for a wonderful dinner. Paano ba naman tayo papayat, no? Every day, meron tayong invitation, no? We really had to lose weight, but it's so difficult. All right. So again, before I properly introduce my guest for tonight, gusto ko lang medyo meron tayong konting background. Ano ba yung meron sa Central Luzon? Okay. Our company REHub, we have core group purposely focusing only in Central Luzon. And it is under our Senior Vice President Robertson Lim, VP Joel Ramos, and of course, Lynn Corpus, our Vice President also. They will be discussing, no, mga areas under them. But I just wanted to give you an overview. Pag Central Luzon kasi, from Bulacan, Pampanga, Tarlac, Subic, Clark, lahat yan covered hanggang sa Bataan are all under Central Luzon. So, nakita natin, no, sa New Clark City pa lang, there is over 9,450 hectares. This project will relocate most government offices from Metro Manila to Central Luzon and is expected to have population of about 1.2 million people upon completion in 2030. Why very important alam natin yung mga ganitong data? Kasi alam natin kung saan tayo mag-i-invest habang hindi pa kamahalan ng mga property doon and medyo marami pa tayong makukuha na medyo mga potential. That is why it is always important for us to be updated. Next. And sa North-South Commuter Rail naman project, the NSCR, this is a high-quality commuter project that has a total length of 147 kilometers from Clark to Calamba, Laguna. With this elevated electrical railway, North Luzon and South Luzon will be fully connected. The 54-kilometer PNR Clark Phase 2 segment, which will run from Malolos in Bulacan to Clark in Pampanga. Yan, napaka-importante, no? Kasi biruin mo, para na tayo na sa Japan, meron tayong talagang high-speed na railway. And we're going there. If you can notice, no, talaga na-appreciate natin ngayon yung mga ano natin, mga infrastructure kagaya ng mga bypass na nagbubukas, no? Yan. All right? Then for the Subic Clark Cargo Railway, another project with an aim to reduce traffic in Metro Manila and ease logistic transport in that area. This project will connect Subic Port and Clark International Airport. The 72 kilometers Subic Cargo Railway will start 2022, after the project has done substantial preparation of the project. This project will make logistics easier, thus will have a positive impact on consumer good prices. Alam mo, napaka-importante kasi ang handling, ang costing natin sa logistics is play a big factor, no, in our ano in the price ng mga commodities na binibenta. You know, pagka mahal ang warehousing mo, mahal ang logistic mo, mahal ang lahat, then syempre your cost will also be high, which domino effect yan. All right, next. Of course, we also have the Tarlac Pangasinan La Union Expressway, yan yung TIPLEX na sinasabi natin. The Tarlac Pangasinan La Union Expressway was completed last July 2021 and can now be fully utilized from Tarlac City and Rosario La Union. The 89-kilometer expressway that benefit 20,000 travelers per day. Kasi alam mo, dinidiscongest natin, no? Kasi congested. Kailangan i-discongested. Kailangan magkaroon ng mga ibang outskirt na parang daanan para naman even provinces mabubuhay, no? Hindi kagaya ng mga ano na hindi walang earth movement kasi naka-centralize sa nagsisiksikan sa mga places where in fact na maraming mga outskirt, napakalaking kalupaan natin sa Pilipinas, no? All right? So, of course, the Central Luzon Link Expressway Phase 1, the 30-kilometer four-lane expressway from Tarlac to Cabanatuan, Nueva Ecija will benefit motorists daily by reducing travel time from 70 minutes to 20 minutes. Biruin mo, di ba sabi nga natin, time is gold. So we have to value our time. Imagine if you are traveling before for 70 minutes, which is equivalent to 1 hour and 10 minutes. So you can now reach your destination within 20 minutes, no? With an efficient exit to Cabanatuan, Nueva Ecija Economic Capital. It is expected that business will be able to thrive more efficiently across the cities. No? So napakaganda, very promising. Yan yun ating project na ating government na build, no? Yan. And I'd like to introduce, no, of course, our mga gentlemen in the house, no? Unahin natin si Mr. Joel BAUIN, our REHub VP Central Luzon, also a licensed broker and by profession, licensed professional teacher. Hi, Joel. Good evening.
Good evening po. Good evening, everybody. Good evening, Doc Mary.
All right. So, good evening din. Batiin muna, introduce muna natin ng ating mga ibang kasamahan pa. And of course, our next speaker for tonight is none other than the President of the Metro Angeles Real Estate Board of PAREB, PAREB National Director for 2023, Interim Trustee Philres Pampanga, Accredited Philippine Mediator Center, a graduate of BSECE, work in electronic company, sound engineer, product and process engineer, and research and development, Japanese company. Work in e-commerce, company as an user, interface designer, web dev, and former owner of a solar design and installation. And studying social, economic, and white hat for cyber security. None other than our president, SHERWIN MALIT. Hi, SHERWIN. Good evening.
Good evening, everyone.
Yan. Ang ating gwapong presidente, SHERWIN. How are you?
I'm okay, ma'am. It's nice to be here, po.
Glad to have you with us tonight and glad to meet you. The first part ng taon, which is the first week of January, no? Medyo nag-planning tayo sa Central Luzon and we're glad we were able to catch you up. And of course, our next speaker and guest, no? Very close to my heart, very dear, napaka-sipag, wala akong masabi. He is our Senior Vice President of REHub in our Central Luzon. I also a licensed broker since 2016, Mr. Robertson Lim. Hi, Robert. Good evening.
Hi, Doc. Good evening po. Good evening to everyone. Nice to be here.
Yan. Alam ko napakaraming mga ano na, mga followers to mga speakers natin for tonight. Eh. And of course, they are all excited no, to listen sa mga isi-share natin. Mga isi-share natin ng mga valuable inputs where the developments are, no? Kasi hindi naman lahat are aware, di ba? Kunyari, pag taga-South ka, hindi ka naman alam, hindi mo naman, hindi ka aware kung ano yung mga developments sa North, no? And with this, because sabi nga natin, in real talk, real estate, there's always a lot of learning. Bago uminit ang ating mga usapan, batiin muna natin ang mga nanonood sa atin from Hermosa, Bataan, Miss Rosalia, Buenaventura. And of course, we also have from San Jose del Monte, Bulacan, si Presencia Plandes. Yan, mga follower niyo ata. Of course, our house pastor, Miss Pastor Ed Kaalim, no, streaming from Bacoor, Cavite. Yan. And of course, Len Reyes, Field Rest Pampanga chapter. Na, hi Len, kumusta? Anak din niya, no? Talagang mga ano yung tandem ng mother-daughter. And we have our BP, Miss Lorna Estacio. Good evening, everyone, and to all. Yan. Of course, Venice D. Greetings from Ribap Mandaluyong. Alright. Isa ako sa mga suki din sa Ribap Mandaluyong. Kaya, thank you for watching. And of course, one of our BP, Miss Monette Rabanillo. Good evening to Dr. Mary Gaw So and everyone. And of course, our brokerage custodian, Miss Loida Saginsing, watching from Quezon City. Yan. From Barangay Kilala, Marawi City. Talagang ano tayo, no? Encompassing, malayo na re-reach out natin. From Karima, Gulam, Akasa. We have also nag-attendance, no? Si Annalisa Bolus, Monguera, present daw. And of course, Ribap Mandaluyong, Mirna, Nolasco. And of course, si Maribik, Marites, and ating mga kasamahan dyan sa rehab. Binabati natin lahat ang mga nanonood sa atin. And of course, our senior account officer, also a licensed broker, Miss Rose Recumin, Dr. Mary, and Central Luzon, excited to hear from your share of your expertise. Alright, dyan pa lang, ubos na ang panahon natin. Let's, ito, may special eh. Special to Sir Joel daw eh. Mukhang follower talaga, balik mo nga doon. Other than the Zamboanga City, no, si Annaline Fuentebella. Si Joel may follower. Eh? Alright. Ayun, Darrell Dian Puertos Logmok. Yan, especially to Sir Joel. Paano naman kami? May special, ganun. Okay, anyway, sige, let's greet the rest mamaya after natin ang talk natin. We just wanted to give the floor, no, to our speaker for tonight. So may we give the floor, no, Sir Joel?
Hello. Good evening, everyone. Before I begin my presentation, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Doc Mary, President of Rehab, and also to both gentlemen, si Sir Sherwin and Sir Robert Lim, together with us. Okay. So what are the development projects in Central Luzon? So tonight we are going to highlight the upcoming infrastructures projects here in Bulacan, Bataan, and Pampanga. In Bataan kay Sir Robert and Pampanga with kay Sir Sherwin Mali. Central Luzon is one of the best growing regions in the country. Number one, it is the next province from Metro Manila. So this region promises growth and advancement with regards to economy and infrastructure. So lahat ng mga development more on nakatutok ngayon dito sa Central Luzon. Central Luzon has a expressway network program. Next tayo, sir. As you can see on the slide, andiyan si TPLEX, CCLEX. So this is a high standard highways and expressways in Luzon. So more on ng tatamaan dyan is the Central Luzon. So madaming mga expressways na tinamaan kay Central Luzon, which is the Tarlac, Nueva Ecija, and then of course Bulacan, Pampanga. So it is a network program para ma-improve to reduce travel time from Ilocos going to Bicol. So from 20 hours, estimate nila, from Ilocos to Bicol, magiging 9 hours na lang. Okay, so let us start with the major infrastructure or development here in Bulacan. So as you can see, magkaroon tayo ng mapping. The first one is the NSCR project or the north to south commuter railway from Tutuban sa Metro Manila going north to Malolos. That is the phase one, the phase one project of the NSCR. So kasi continuous yan to Clark. Then the Bulacan International Airport and Aero City. So before, nagkakaroon ng mga rumors na hindi matutuloy yung Bulacan Airport, pero ngayon continuous yung construction niya. Then the MRT Line 7, the NGC, Mega Worlds NGC, and the Bulacan Circle C1 to C6. So another road going to south. Okay, next po. Okay, let us start with the Mega Worlds Northwind Global City. So kung sa Taguig meron tayong BGC dito sa Central Luzon or sa Bulacan, magkakaroon tayo ng Mega Worlds NGC or the Northwind Global City. This is the 28 townships of Mega World along NLEX. So kung makikita niyo do sa pictures, lang siya, halos nasa diversion road ng Marilao and Bukawi. So makikita niyo rin sa pictures yung Philippine Arena. This is a 85 hectare community. Then yung 16 hectares doon is devoted to its central business district. So another big development to na nag-invest yung isang yung mga investors dito sa Bulacan. Kasi number one, nakita din nila yung mga yung mga future or upcoming infrastructure project ng government dito sa Central Luzon. So nakita nila yon. So isa-isahin natin yung mga development or major development dito sa Central Luzon. First one is the International Airport and Aero City. So as you can see, yung reclamation nila ay medyo lumalaki na. Yung activity nila doon ay tuloy-tuloy lang din. This is a 2,500 hectare airport, and then 12,000 hectare township with a residential zone. And then yung mga government center, government offices, maglalagay din sila dyan. So parang magkakaroon ng mini community. So yung ibang mga investors nakapag-put up na ng land banking dito sa around Ubando, Bulacan, hindi pa nagkakaroon ng earth movement doon sa area, pero yung iba since nalaman kagad nila na magkakaroon ng major development or infrastructure dito sa Bulacan, nag-umpisa na kagad sila mag land banking. So next tayo. This is a massive yung Aero City. This is a green design and future ready Aero City development here in Bulacan. Next, another infrastructure project here, the NSCR or the North to South Commuter Railway, phase 1. So phase 1 lang to, Tutuban to Malolos. This is a commuter railway. So this will help to decongest land traffic. So yung syempre yung iba, instead na lalo mahal ang gasolina ngayon, tapos tumataas ang mga ang toll fee. So malaking bagay tong railway na for the commuters, and also mabawasan yung traffic. Then the MRT line 7, ito naman yung northeast to southwest direction from San Jose del Monte, Bulacan to North Avenue, Quezon City. So another big development din to, madami na nag-aabang dito kasi unang-una yung traffic sa land maiiwasan nila lalo doon sa area ng ano ng Novaliches to ano Novaliches Fairview, sobra ang traffic. So this is a part of the ng mga build project ng ano ng government para sa mga ano sa mga taxpayers or sa mga commuters. So doon sa mga pinakita natin na ano meron tayong railway, so meron ding ano mga big development ng mga developers, syempre kailangan iayos din yung ano yung road networks natin. Nagkakaroon tayo ng kasi sa ano naman sa isang area naman once na develop or nagkaroon ng infrastructure ang ano ang government, ano yan eh, nilalapitan ng mga investors yan. The area becomes feasible and profitable pagka nagkaroon ng mga ano infrastructure. So definitely dadami yung volume ng sasakyan, yung tao. So we doon papasok pa yan yung mga ano mga roads na ginagawa ng DPWH. So they are making bypass roads. So yung bypass road siya yung parang ano ini-skip niya yung traffic doon sa area. So ang nangyayari kung hindi ka naman doon talaga dadaan doon sa kung saan nagbi-build up yung traffic, pwede kang dumaan doon sa bypass road. So nakakabawas ngayon ng mga ano ng volume ng sasakyan doon sa area na yon. Okay, so we have different bypass road. So meron tayo Pandi bypass road that is 13 kilometers from Santa Maria to Plaridel. Then yung isa sa pinakamahaba yung Balagtas bypass road that is from Balagtas Bulacan to San Rafael. Then dudugtungan yon from San Rafael to ano Tugapan. Then the San Jose del Monte bypass road. Next sir. Tapos different roads na gagawin going to Dingalan to Nueva Ecija. So this will help sa logistics na yung katulad nung nabanggit ni Doc Mary kanina, the more na mas mataas yung operation natin sa ano sa warehousing, sa logistics, tumataas yung presyo. So dito hindi tayo ma-traffic or hindi ka ma kumbaga ma-less yung cost ng mobilization mo is a big factor sa isang ano sa prices ng mga goods natin. So ito yan yung mga bypass and the provincial and national roads na ginagawa dito sa Bulacan. Okay, so ito yung sample ng isang bypass road dito sa Bulacan. Consists of 4 lanes. Meron tayong lane for bike sa mga nagbabike tsaka sa mga nagmomotor. Meron siyang lanes sa outer lane sila. Pwede silang magano. Parang sa Manila din, 'di ba? Merong mga may mga bike lane and motorcycle lane. So dito sa ano sa mga bypass roads natin sa Bulacan meron din 'yan. So ito 'yon, mga 4 lanes bypass road. So isa 'yan sa mga ano mga kasama sa build and mga major infrastructure development dito sa Bulacan. Okay, the C6 or the circumferential road, it will connect the Bulacan, Rizal, Manila, and Cavite, or also called as the BRMCRE. It is a proposed superhighway in Luzon. So mag-i-connect din niya yung ano from sa North Luzon to South Luzon. So it will also helps na mabawasan yung ano yung traffic by land doon sa mga town proppers. Okay, thank you. And next na po si Sir Sherwin.
Good evening. Thank you, Sir Joel. And thank you, Doc Mary, for inviting me here. So for Pampanga, we have the phase two. So this is only updates sa mga project. I think it was discussed before, ano yung mga project sa Pampanga. A bit trivia on Pampanga. Pampanga has a 19 municipalities and two cities, that is San Fernando and Mabalacat. And we have one highly urbanized city, that is Angeles. Angeles is independent city because of its urbanized city. Pero part pa rin siya ng Pampanga, lang naka-independent lang siya. So for the next. For NSCR Project Extension Phase, Malolos to Clark, yung dalawang city po, dalawang airport magkoconnect. So approximately 53.1 kilometers is project beneficial to those living in Bulacan as it connect not only to Clark Economic Zone but also to Clark International and Central Luzon. Broken down into the segments, Malolos Clark section 5.2 kilometers, Blumentritt Extension 1.9 kilometers, Solis and Blumentritt Station in Metro Manila District. Next. Clark Airport serves the Central Luzon, Northern Luzon to an extent Metro Manila. Ito po yung big project ng government to decongest Manila. That's why the development and build project are focusing in Central Luzon. The first airport in the Philippines to have an airport railway, Clark International Airport is also home the country the tallest air traffic control tower. Yes. And the next project, it's Subic Clark Railway. The Subic Clark project, which is a part of North South Commuter Railway of the PNR Luzon system. Development framework with purpose providing cargo freight service and will be available for commuters between two regions. That is the seaport, which is Subic, and the airport is Clark. Next, sir. Here are the some development in Angeles. The Kutkut Bridge or project located intersection between Angeles Porac Road, Telebastagan Friendship Highway. The Friendship Highway is one of the project of the tourism and DPWH to create a 6-lane road. Then nag-heavy po yung traffic dito. So the government decide or to build a flyover to lessen the traffic. Ito po ang boundary between Porac and Angeles. The 700 meter flyover, including its approaches, aim to solve the bottleneck in the intersection of Porac Angeles and the Friendship Highway. Right, sir. And the other things, the Delta Bridge. Ito po sa South Pampanga. Yung kanina po Angeles, Mabalacat, and Clark, they are North Pampanga. Sa South Pampanga, may dinevelop din na 270 meters bridge span the Pampanga River connecting Barangay Balibago and Bebe Anak in Masantol Town that will provide better connectivity to the town of Makabebe and Masantol. and estimated completed date for this project has been scheduled for September 2023. Next. And this one, sa South Pampanga Preto. It's Lubao, Gagwagwa, Sasmuan, Minalin, Santo Tomas Bypass Road. Ito po, nag-access na po ito. Dito po kasi sa South Pampanga, marami pong agriculture dyan, like the shrimp, mga fish pond, and eggs, egg layer. Dito po sa South Pampanga. Next. Regional Government Office. Located in the city of San Fernando are various regional government offices. Nandito rin po ang Pampanga po kasi ang center niya ay San Fernando. So marami rin pong nagtayong government offices para mag-congested po yung sa Manila. Next. Ito po, why invest in Central Luzon? There are a lot of reasons. Most of the brokers and real estate practitioner, alam nila why invest in Central Luzon. Because it is a urban economic growth. A lot to offer for people who want to settle in less dense area than Metro Manila and are looking for great economic opportunities. Growth is the evidence here as seen in Central Luzon construction boom over the past decades, which has been the rise of condominiums, hotels, resort, casinos, international restaurants, shopping mall, connecting roads, trains, and recreational complex. Yeah. Why invest pa rin in Central Luzon? Aerotropolis in Central Luzon. There are a lot of aerotropolis in Asia. Isa dyan ang Japan, and Hong Kong, Macau, and China. Because of the aerotropolis, yan po ang isang sign of booming place because of the airport. Pagsabi pong aerotropolis is, airport is the center of the area. The Clark Free Zone, Freeport, and Special Economic Zone, a former U.S. military base, that is being touted as the current investment center in Asia. As special economic zone, Clark was seen to provide employment as the area became the civil aviation complex and tourism, trade and business center in the zone. The government built initiative led to several infrastructure projects lined up in Clark and more to come. Ito po kanina yung Aetropolis. Nag-research din ako ba why Aetropolis? Kasi meron tayong Metropolis and Aetropolis. Metropolis is like the green city and the big city. But Aetropolis is one of their business is the air or yung by like airport. Each businessman and other companies, they like JIT or just on time sa mga seminars and products. To save time. So Aetropolis, a new urban form where cities are built around airport. Speedy connecting time sensitive suppliers, manufacturers, distributor, business people to distant customer, client and marketplace. Yes. The other thing is the green city or the new Clark City. Kanina na-mention ni Doc Mary about the Clark, the new Clark City. It's planning community card undergoing development located within Clark Special Economic Zone. It has an area of approximately 9,450 hectares and accommodate at 1.2 million. Checking the Pampanga population for 2020, we are around 2.4 million. But the Pampanga or Central Luzon, a part of Central Luzon, Pampanga, we have an area of 2,000 square kilometer or square miles, 772 square miles. ang area po ng Pampanga. So, napakalaki pa ang pwedeng i-develop. Yes. Green City or the New Clark City, merging with nature, the heart of the New Clark City is proposed to be the Central Park and Business District wrapped around it that has a magnificent views of the hill. Kung ang pagkakaiba po or advantage po ng Pampanga, we have the good landscape. On the east side, we have the Mount Arayat, and the west side is the Mount Pinatubo Mountains beside it. It's served by public transport, housing, and industry from the other layers. In network of open space form, the bound between diverse mixed-use district. The city is stated that to be the country's first smart, resilient, and environmental-friendly metropolis. It tries to solve rising environment challenges caused by climate change by becoming catastrophe resilient in an area prone to natural disaster. Yes. Ito po yung the city is intended. Oops. Umalik po. Next po. The city is intended to be a model for other cities in Philippines and around the world. When it comes to building sustainable, livable cities, New York City is leading the way. This innovative new development is designed to be the model other cities in the Philippines and around the world, setting a new standard in urban living. New Clark City is built on principle of sustainable with features like green space, pedestrian-friendly street, and energy-efficient building. The city is also designed to be highly livable with ample amenities and well-connected transport network. Next. Karamihan po sa, marami po sa Clark, especially po dito sa area, there are a lot of investors coming in. Most of them, they are foreign because they see the more faster in the airport traveling their products from other countries. The Business Conversion and Development Authority, BCDA, is spearheading the development of a new Clark City or Clark Green City. The overall master plan development is under BCDA. BCDA signed a 50-year contract with PhilInvest to develop the 288 hectares or 710 acres of land located for the project. BCDA also managed to make partnership with the foreign firms to develop Clark Green City, such Japanese Overseas Infrastructure Investment Corporation. New Clark City has recently been enlightened by the Urban Land Institute, or the ULI, ULI, Philippines as a model and benchmark for the country's future cities after taking a more sustainable approach to resolving urgent urbanization issues like flooding, traffic, and congestion, as well as air and water pollution. Mag-additional lang po ako. Ang Clark po, kung makita natin sa mga in the news and updates, there are a lot of movement and development. And the city and the urban planning ng Clark, there are series of projects that their continuity, starting from the president of the Philippines before Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo up to BBM, they are making continuity of the project, which gives the whole Philippines for the interconnecting of airports via train and the land network, especially in Central Luzon, that connecting from north, south, west and east to give the agriculture business also to help mabilis po ang pag-deliver to lessen the cost and to give more mapunta po yung product sa mga other municipality or province in the right time. Hindi po sila nagtatagal ng months or weeks or days sa mga warehouse. So they're looking for a jeep delivery always on time or just on time ma-delivery nila. Well, that's my update for Central Luzon. Thank you. I'll give to Sir Robert.
Hello, good evening. Tonight, I'm going to present to you the province of Bataan and why we should invest in province of Bataan. First, Bataan is one of the farthest location sa Central Luzon. So, katulad siya ng Zambales and then ng Aurora, you have to pass through many provinces muna before reaching Bataan. So it's composed of towns, mostly agricultural and fishing areas. Next slide, please. The link of to Bataan, before there's only at least one road going to Bataan, that's the Jose Abadsanos Road or yung Olongapo-Gaban Road. But now, it can be reached by different road network. Number one is the Olongapo-Gaban pa rin. Number two, yung Esitec na natin going straight to Dinalupihan. And then there will be another road network. Kasi right now, if you want to go to Subic, you have to go past Dau. But right now, they're making another toll gate that you will just cross Santo Tomas. That's the toll gate before San Fernando, and then you will pass by the provinces of the towns of Pampanga, and then going to Bataan. Next slide, please. So this is one of the projects that Central Luzon is very. We are very proud of this project and we are very, very excited of this because Bataan will now be reachable at least 1.5 hours from Manila. Right now, going to Bataan, it will take you around 3 to 4 hours to reach Bataan. But this one, dahil dito sa Bataan, Cavite Interlink, you can reach Bataan from Metro Manila in just 1.5 hours. And then Cavite to Bataan is just 30 to 40 minutes. Now, the advantage of this bridge, mostly the products of Southern Luzon cannot reach Bataan or cannot reach even Pampanga. But at this project, the Bataan-Cavite Interlink Bridge, which costs 175 billion, the logistic now will be easier to come to Bataan. Next slide, please. Next is the Bataan Harbor City. So now this is a project ng Pilar Town. And then it is a 4 billion project na gagawa sila ng diversity na nandun na lahat. Meron na tayong port, meron na tayong houses, golf course, and then meron pa tayong mga medium and light industries, and then the houses. So imagine, to decongest the port of Manila, they will be making another port here in Bataan. So delivery for the products in Central Luzon, kasama na po ang Northern Luzon, would only be transported to Bataan, not to Metro Manila, to decongest the traffic in Metro Manila. It is a 4 billion project. At this time, nakakuha na po ng at least 2.3 billion sa DBP ang contractor nito. So the project is well and doing good. Next slide, please. We have also the Philippine Sports Training Center in Bagak. This one po, because Bataan is not only thinking about the industry, it's also thinking about building the future of the Filipino athletes. So they are going to construct a 55 million road pa lang po yun, and the total project is about 3.5 billion. It will consist of all the athletics arena, and then the tennis court, kasama na po dyan yung mga admin, medical center, sports sciences, dormitory, diving pool, and then the Olympic size swimming pool. This would be ongoing, and then tapos na po yung ano, nag-break, nag-ano na sila, nag-start na po sila ng construction. So next slide please. Is the convention center. This one would be built in Balanga City in Bataan. The convention center is it will be used for science, the arts, and then some conventions na gagawin for Bataan. This one po, meron po siyang ano, meron po siyang kasamang terminal, and then it is a 4.6 hectares na location sa Balanga, Bataan. Because Bataan is proud of its fishing industry, that's why they designed it in the form of a fish. So next slide please. And then this one, Vista Estate, Micro City. Bataan is not only after the industrial, the science and the arts, and then the commercial, they are also thinking of projects for our residential. So this one, it is a family-oriented eco-center master plan. It is being designed and built by Vista Estate. This is one of the first projects in Bataan, which is a pro-planet, a pro-people, and with a renewable energy around the subdivision. So this is one of the projects that we are looking forward for. So next po. I want to share to you right now the advantage of doing business in Bataan. Bataan right now has a we called a FAB, which is it is called a freeport area of Bataan. So how to do business in Bataan would be easier if you are under the freeport area. The advantage is, number one, you have a superior location. And then next, you also have a superior facility, which is state of the art. And then Bataan will also give you tax incentives to do with it, free import. And then the way of doing business would be easier because of this program of Bataan government, which is the FAB. That's all. Thank you.
All right. Grabe. Alam mo, ako nakikinig pa lang sa inyo. Sobrang daming development in different beautiful places in Central Luzon. Hearing from the expert, local, from Pampanga, Bulacan, Bataan, no? So napakaraming development left and right. And with that, there's no reason for all our investors na mahuli, no, sa pag-i-invest, kasi meron na tayong mga first-hand information, and we are not creating stories, but these are really on the table, and these are others are ongoing, and a lot of other project coming up soon. So wag na tayong patulog-tulog. But before that, marami tayong dapat batiin, but I want to ask the three gentlemen natin na bisita for tonight, na what are the advantages of that, ano, di ba you presented different provinces compared to other province which was presented by others. So i-compare lang natin, kumbaga, kasi syempre sa dami, no, ang next na tanong ng investor, maganda si Bataan, maganda si Pampanga, maganda si, saan ako ngayon with this budget ko, no, small or big, saan basket ko maganda ilagay. So may we hear first from Sir Joel.
Here in Bulacan, since na siya yung next province from Metro Manila, siya yung naging hot seat ng mga many investors galing Metro Manila for some issues like congestions, and yung iba namang city from Metro Manila nagkakaroon ng tax issues, medyo nilalakihan pagdating sa mga industrial yung percentage ng tax. So definitely yung ibang investors or manufacturing, lumilipat sila dito sa Bulacan since pagdating sa mobilization nila hindi naman ganun din kabigat, or yung additional cost nila in operation hindi ganun tumaas unlike nung nasa Metro Manila sila. So yun yung isang advantage ng Bulacan. Then aside from that, si Bulacan is awarded from Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry as most friendly province in terms of business. So na-awardan ng province of Bulacan.
Ayan. So napakaganda nung sagot ni Sir Joel. Tama nga naman. After Valenzuela, Bulacan na, no? So nearest to Metro Manila. So again, siyempre alam natin nga, sabi ko, the investors, our viewers are might probably wanted to kasi alam mo Maki, for decision making kailangan medyo ma-equip natin in terms of data, in terms of mga facts na talagang derivative and back up talaga ng mga totoong mga totoong kunyari awarded as ganito. So hindi naman natin pwedeng i-oversell without really the actual, no, na talagang ng per area, per province. All right, may we hear from the president, no, Sherwin of MAREB Metro Angeles.
Thank you, ma'am. Other province dito sa Central Luzon are okay. But the Pampanga is one of the fastest growing due to the Aeropolis project. All the roads that mentioned kanina, SETEX, NLEX, CALEX, all the expressway are passing Pampanga. So, yung first circle ng Pampanga, that is Angeles, and inside it, Porac, Mabalacat, palabas po yan, going outside, and going outside Pampanga. Any Clark is also a magnet of investor and business opportunity. Kung sa Pampanga po, sabi po nila, masarap daw yung pagkain dito. So, marami rin pong magpupunta because of the food and the tourism. And of course, because of Clark Special Economic Zone, that has a complete package. From the airport, going to the north, Baguio. And west, it is Subic. And the east side is Nueva Ecija and other agribusiness going there. And south is Metro Manila. And a series of build project. Kanina po, tinawagan ko po ang government sa inside Clark, what are their project. They're mentioning to me, marami pa silang gagawin. So the funding is continuing growing because the Aerotropolis, once connected po yan, everything is fast po lahat, mabibilis ang mga daan and the train. And of course, the landscape. It is a nature dahil hindi pa po siya ganun ka-develop. We have the nature of the mountain. And kung nandito po sa province, dahil hindi pa ganyan ka-high dense, so marami pang room for development and wider road. So the project is still growing. So that is in Pampanga or Central Luzon.
Ayun! From President Sherwin, alam mo sa haba ng sinabi mo, doon lang ako naka-focus sa maraming masarap na pagkain dahil I love food so much. So I think our Senior Vice President Robertson Lim will totally agree with me. So from Bulacan to Pampanga, na comparable natin, let's hear from Senior VP Robertson Lim. How about Bataan? Ano naman ang ating
yes.
pagmalaki?
For me, Bataan. Itaas ang bandila ng Bataan. No, yes. For me, it's Bataan. Why? Number one, ang na-develop po kasi sa Bataan na road network, sa Bulacan, may bypass siya. Pero ang Bataan kasi meron na siyang bypass way before. It is now called Roman Highway. The old road of Bataan will pass through many towns, yung mga poblasyon, mga houses. But this time, yung Roman Highway is a highway that crosses Bataan, that's para siyang spine po or skeletal, pero wala siyang masyadong development. So, as you can see, ang commercial prices natin na tabing daan ng Roman Highway is cheaper than Bulacan and Pampanga, number one, number two. Number three, pagdating po sa manufacturing, only Bataan has port. It has a port of Mariveles, and most of us doesn't know that SBMA, part of it is Bataan. So we have two ports in Bataan. We have lower electricity because the coal power plant is here. Maybe lower in gas or diesel because the refineries are here. And then we are also number one in Central Luzon pagdating sa Human Development Index. So the people here are teachable and very easy to adapt kung ano yung work skill na dapat gawin. So for me, it's better to invest in Bataan. Although we are farthest right now from Manila, but after the bridge is finished, would be the nearest, same as Pampanga and same as Bulacan. So that's it po. Invest in Bataan.
Yan, meron medyo may ano, competitive lahat ah. May mga kanya-kanyang beauty of the city. Ayan, all right. So, alam mo, parating kalaban natin dito is oras, no? Ang sarap ng kwentuhan natin, and it's an hour already. And I would like to hear from each of our speakers ng your last message to all our viewers, and kung meron kayong gustong batiin, umpisahan naman natin uli, pabaliktad, kay Senior VP Robertson Lim, then to be followed by our President of Metro Angeles, SHERWIN, and our Vice President for Central Luzon, Mr. Joel Ramos. All right.
Good evening ulit. I want to thank my family na nagsusupport sa akin lagi. Being a broker is not an easy job. Sometimes, hindi maintindihan na laging wala ka sa bahay. But I want to invite everybody to see the Central Luzon, especially yung mga in-offer ng rehab. We offer the best, and we are very skillful sa mga trabaho natin. So I want you to contact us, especially Central Luzon. Please give us a chance to offer you properties here. Thank you.
All right. So thank you, our Senior Vice President Robertson Lim. Mr. SHERWIN?
Yes, Doc. Kanina po na-mention yung mga development dito. I will promote rehab. Rehab is one of the promising real estate services. They have a lot of property for you to buy. And thank you, Doc, for inviting me here, for sharing what are the best in Pampanga. And we'll promote, of course, sa mga buyers or investors, please use broker in buying property para po your investments really safe for you. Thanks po, Dr. Mary.
Yan. So, totoo yan, no? Iba talaga, syempre, pag mayroong broker na nag-handle ng yung transaction, it would just like something that you don't have to miss dahil, alam mo, the component of making the due diligence, the proper documentation, the proper taxes that you have to pay, no, alam no, pinag-anuhan natin yung mga brokers na pinag-aralan, kaya we know better than the buyer because sometimes the buyer is not really habitually buying or engaged in real estate. So tayo, we have the authority to advise, right, to our client kung ano yung mga dapat nilang gawin and ano yung mga dapat na expectation. And always, there's no surprises, please. We have to lay down every single things that we have to disclose para naman alam ng buyer ang expectation nila. And the same way, sa seller side, we also have to share and educate our seller what are mga things that they are expecting So those are really mga trabaho natin as broker, being professional in this industry. All right. Of course, ang ating VP ng Rehab Central Luzon, Joel, may we hear from you.
Yes po, Doc. Tama po. Yung pagiging real estate broker, very challenging, lalo sa mga ano pagdating sa documentation. Tapos, yung iba, hindi pa nilalay down lahat ng mga details or information. Tama po yung sinabi niyo, Doc, na minsan may mga surprises pagdating na andyan na si buyer, andyan na yung client. Tsaka natin magkakaalaman, may ganito palang issues, may gantong problema. So, yan yung mga trabaho ng pagiging broker at na masaya ako na naging part ako ng Real Estate Hub, naging well-equipped ako pagdating sa mga ganyang, ano, ganyang matters.
Alright, thank you again to the three gentlemen natin for tonight. And it was really such a wonderful discussion about the beauty in Central Luzon. And with that, of course, we will not be ending the show without any baon for everyone, no? So we'd like to share with you, of course, some business opportunities. We'd like to invite you, of course, to our opening of our new building to serve you better. And of course, your take home for the Bible verse. May we have the screen, please? Thank you, Joel. Thank you, Sir Robert. Thank you, Sherwin. All right. So again, it's full of learning, no? So always tune in at CBRC.tv every Saturday, 7 to 8 o'clock here at Real Talk Real Estate. And of course, sa mga properties na binibenta namin, kung kayo nagpabenta, kung kayo bibili, always look for us for anything that we can share. We have a lot of inventories, no? Sa Malolo, sa may Bulacan, sa Bataan, no? Yan. All right, so hopefully we can be of service if you want to depende sa appetite ng inyong budget, depende sa appetite ng location. So we will always make sure that we will do search the best property that will match your interest. All right, next. And continues calling for anyone who is interested to join our team, of course, for marketing staff, for civil engineer, for legal, and for other vacant position at Rehab and My Hometown Realty. Okay, so inviting you to drop by in our office at the 60 Scout Chotoco Corner, Champaca. From our group of companies, we have My Hometown, Garbs, Tronics Master, Panay Kain Tulog, BGC, Sightsaber Optical, Arvas, Arizona, and all a blessed Saturday and stay safe. For all those who wanted to sell your property, just reach out to us. We are already 25 years in this industry. Yan. Thank you for Real Estate PH News, no? For coming up always with hot news, my friend Andy Manyala. Thank you for CBRC.TV for giving us the award last 2021 for best host, most generous host, and most innovative show. Again, from Luke 21:33, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will by no means pass away. With that, my life verse, Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. God bless. Blessed Saturday. Have a nice weekend. Take care.
Do you want to sell or acquire a property? Rehab and My Hometown Realty and Developer, with a wide range of real estate services for individual, corporate, or business clients, from brokerage, project selling, to property management, leasing, engineering, appraisal services, documentation services. Real Estate Hub, 25 years in the real estate industry. Our chairman, Ms. Margaret Gao, a licensed real estate broker.
and a certified international property specialist. Our president, Dr. Mary Gaw So, a licensed broker, appraiser, and consultant. Certified international property specialist. 2019 ASEAN Real Estate Network Alliance Arena Top Broker. Our CEO, Mr. Winston Gaw, together with his wife, Claire Gaw, handle international linkages. Check out our website at www.realestatehub.com.ph.